DC Comics has debuted a new Batman. For the first time in 82 years, a person of color is putting on the cowl of the Caped Crusader. And the writer behind this superhero is also black. Some readers see this as a step in the right direction for ethnic representation. As Phil Carpenter reports, the industry still has a long way to go to improve diversity in comic books.
At first, illustrator Latif Martin was skeptical when he heard about DC Comics' new superhero character. He thought it'd be just another story paying lip service to diversity.
You know, black is in, let's cash in on it.
In December, the comic book giant revealed that the next version of Batman would have a black man behind the cowl. He appears in a new four-part comic series called Future State, The New Batman. Once he got a copy, Martin became less cynical, partly because the character portraying Batman is so well known to longtime fans and wasn't just suddenly invented to fill a quota.
Tim Fox, there's a relationship with Batman, with the whole lineage of, Lucius Fox being the person who, created all the gear for him.
Martin is happy because the writer behind the work is also a man of color, John Ridley, the Oscar-winning screenwriter of 12 Years a Slave. Ridley was thrilled to help evolve the character for his kids and other kids of color.
Who love these stories but just don't quite see themselves in these stories, that means the most to me.
Martin agrees that it helps for kids to see themselves in these stories. As a black kid in Montreal, he rarely saw someone he could really relate to in comic books and on TV.
Time and again, I'm always disappointed. Oh, where's the black guy? Oh, he's the butler. Okay. Where's the black guy? Oh, he's the pimp. Where's the black guy? Oh, he's the thug.
Tara Paul co-hosts a podcast about comic books. She and her colleagues have been pushing for more diversity in comics too.
We've been waiting for more representation, that folks that can represent us and the superhero world.
With this character though, Ridley wants readers to go beyond skin color. He says the story is less about the character's race than his experiences as a person.
This is not Black Batman. This is Jace Fox, who is a person of color, who is black, who becomes Batman.
There are those who say that with the push for diversity in representation comes the risk of tokenism, which some experts feel media giants like DC and Marvel struggle with.
The name black often appears in their name, their superhero name, as if to say that, that's the defining feature, right?
Some have argued that even the name Black Panther is an example of tokenism.
I really think it's all about how the thing is treated and also who is behind the scenes.
Ridley agrees that diversity among the creators is also necessary to help make the characters more realistic. Though he believes there is room for improvement, he sees changes for the better.
There is a desire to have characters that are more reflective of the world that we live in,
making the colorful world of comics a place for all kinds of new characters. Phil Carpenter, Global News, Montreal.
That story is part of a new initiative on Global called Perspectives. The site features stories meant to cover and reflect Canada's diverse populations. Check it out at globalnews.ca/perspectives.